Welcome friends, and today we are going to study about pyrogen testing. So what is mean by a pyrogen? It is a substance which is produced by bacterium which produces fever when it is introduced or released into blood. Okay, so we are going to study method for which we can detect pyrogen. The most common pyrogens are endotoxins, which are nothing but lipopolysaccharides produced by gram-negative bacteria. Some exotoxins may be pyrogenic. Okay, exotoxins are known to be occasionally pyrogenic. So next we are going to see about what we are going to study in this tutorial. So actually there are three tests included in pyrogen testing. First is rabbit charm test. Second is LAL test, also known as bacterial endotoxin test. Third is human cell based pyrogen test. Regarding LAL test, I am going to skip in this video as I had already done a video on this, and for LAL test I will mention the link in description box, you can find out there. Then we are going to look about how to depyrogenate your material, methods or techniques for that. Then let's start about rabbit or charm test. Why to use rabbit for this pyrogen testing? Let's see that. Rabbits are economic and they show similar pyrogenic response as that of humans. That's why we are going to use rabbit for this test. This test involves measuring the rise in body temperature in healthy rabbits by intravenous injection of a sterile solution of substance under test. Okay, so the test substance may be injectable water or a product or a drug that is produced in or that is produced by a pharmaceutical company. So this test is actually applied in a pharmaceutical company where to test pyrogen you can use this test. This is critical test as the US pharmacopoeia or the other pharmacopoeia, they recommend this test before passing the product. Okay, so what is the design of this product that we will see? This test is designed by taking rabbits into the consideration that they can tolerate some products or limited products. So this test is designed for products that can be tolerated by rabbits in a dose not exceeding 10 ml per kg. Okay, so there is a limitation for dose for a product that is under test, which is 10 ml per kg. Not more than this limit you can inject. Then we are going to inject intravenously within a period of not more than 10 minutes. First, we need to select healthy rabbits which are good for our test and they can show actual rise in temperature. Okay, so for this test the material which we are required or which we will be using, that should be depyrogenated. For that we need to heat our material in oven at 250 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes or 200 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Okay, then the diluents or solutions that are to be used, they should be sterile and pyrogen free. For recording temperature, thermometer or even you can use thermistors for recording the temperature. So for recording you need to insert the thermometer into the rectum of the test rabbit for the depth of 5 cm and then record the temperature. Next we are going to study about the test which is carried out for animal selection, that is preliminary test. Okay, so here we are not going to use our test solution. Here we are going to use pyrogen free saline solution, okay, which is not having our product which is under test. Okay, So this is a normal saline solution which is pyrogen free that we are going to inject. So first warm this solution up to 38.5 degrees Celsius, then record the temperature of animals at least 90 minutes before injecting the saline solution, and continue recording for 3 hours after injecting. Okay, so why we have to record temperature at least 90 minutes before? This is the initial temperature that we are going to use for our further calculations while interpreting. Then the other point is, exclude any animal which is showing an unusual response to trauma of injection. Due to a shock of injection, a sudden solution which we are injecting, which is having a temperature of 38.5 degrees Celsius, if to that injection if an animal is showing an unusual response, then we have to exclude that animal for our test purpose. Then any animal which is showing a temperature variation greater than 0.6 degrees Celsius is not used in the main test. Okay, so there should not be any temperature variation greater than 0.6 degrees Celsius. Okay, otherwise we are going to exclude that animal for the main test. So let's see what is the main test. Main test is carried out using a group of 3 rabbits. So preparation of test solution. So here we are going to use our test solution that we want to test for pyrogenic response. So for this we first need to dissolve the solution substance properly using appropriate diluents. Then the solution should be pyrogen free. These are the points that you have to take in consideration while preparing your test solution. Okay, here also we are going to warm up the liquid under examination to approximately 38.5 degree Celsius before injecting. Okay, so now we will turn to procedure. Here also we have to take into the consideration some points such as injected volume. There is volume recommended for injection. The minimum volume that you can inject is 0.5 ml per kg, and maximum volume that you can inject is 10 ml per kg of body mass of rabbit. Okay, then we have to record initial temperature for main test. We have to record initial temperature before 40 minutes of injection, and the temperature should not vary of each rabbit in a group. The temperature should not vary by 0.2 degree Celsius. It should not be more than 0.2 degree Celsius. Okay. Then another point is, do not use any rabbit having a temperature higher than 39.8 degree Celsius and lower than 38 degree Celsius. So this is the temperature criteria for healthy rabbit selection. Okay. Here also we are going to apply this criteria. Then injecting the solution. While injecting the solution, inject a solution within a period of not exceeding 4 minutes. Period not exceeding 4 minutes. Okay, so you should inject properly within 4 minutes. And we are going to inject our solution in a marginal vein of ear. Okay, and after injecting, we are going to record the temperature. Remember, the sample is having temperature of 38.5 degrees Celsius when it is injected. After injecting, we are going to record the temperature for each animal at half hour interval for 3 hours after injecting the sample. The difference between initial temperature and maximum temperature, which is the highest temperature recorded for rabbit, is taken to be its response. Okay, so you remember, first we had taken the initial temperature before injecting the solution. We are going to compare the temperature after injecting, and from that the maximum temperature which we had obtained in the 3 hours interval that we will take as the highest temperature and that we will report it as a response to the substance which we are testing. When this difference is negative, the result is counted as a zero response. This can happen. A drug may not be pyrogenic. Okay, so here there will be no rise in temperature. So in this case, the result is counted as zero response. Okay, so you will conclude in your report that the substance is not pyrogenic. Okay, so next we are going to see about interpretation of results. Okay, so we had grouped 3 rabbits in a group and we will check the rise in temperature for each of the rabbit in half hour interval for 3 hours. Okay, so if the response of the group of 3 rabbits in which individual response is less than 0.6 degrees Celsius, the preparation being examined passes the test. Okay, if the response of the group of 3 rabbits in which individual response, okay, so out of 3 we are talking about rabbit, one rabbit showing response less than 0.6 degrees Celsius, the preparation being examined passes the test. Okay, so this is one case. The another case is if the response of any rabbit is 0.6 degrees Celsius or more. Okay, out of 3, if one rabbit is showing a response of 0.6 degrees Celsius or more, or if the sum of response of 3 rabbits, okay, if we are going to consider the response of all 3 rabbits, and if the sum of all 3 rabbits' response is more than 1.4 degrees Celsius, then continue the test using 5 other rabbits in a group. Okay, so we will add 5 more rabbits to the group and now we will test the substance against these 8 rabbits. Okay, so now we will see the third case regarding this 8 rabbits. Here, if not more than 3 of 8 rabbits, if not more than 3 of 8 rabbits, they show individual response of 0.6 degrees Celsius or more, and if the sum of response of the group of 8 rabbit does not exceed 3.7 degrees Celsius, the preparation being examined passes the test. Please study this carefully, understand this carefully. If the response of 3 rabbits from 8 rabbits show individual response of 0.6 degrees Celsius or more, and if the sum of responses of group of 8 rabbit does not exceed 3.7 degrees Celsius, okay, it is not more than 3.7 degrees Celsius, then it passes. And if the sum of 8 rabbits response is more than that, more than 3.7, then the test substance will fail the test, okay, it will not pass. So these are the different cases, 3 cases where the response is calculated in a different way. So please understand each case and write it well in your answers. Next we are going to study about advantages and disadvantages for rabbit test, or also known as sham test. So the first advantage is use of rabbits. Why use of rabbits? We had seen that because they can replicate and demonstrate the production of fever in humans. Okay, the response of fever is same as that in humans. Next is the detection level by sham test is good as it detects all kinds of injectable pyrogen, unlike Lal test. Okay, so this is the advantage for sham test. and same point is a limitation for large test. Okay, so disadvantages for sham test: it is time consuming and expensive, as we are going to handle a group of rabbits where you need to record the temperature for half hour interval for each rabbit. So this is time consuming and expensive, as we are using animals and we need to maintain their health and their hygiene. So this test is expensive. The disadvantages: animal use. This is the another disadvantage, as we are harming animals, we are using them for testing our drugs or products in lab. So this is the disadvantage of this test. Another disadvantage is tolerance that is created in certain tolerance that is created by some rabbits in due to some certain class of drugs. Okay, so by using or due to testing of a drug, it can happen that a rabbit can develop tolerance and the rabbit cannot show or will not show any pyrogenic effect. So your test may go wrong in that case. So this is the one at disadvantage. Another one is it cannot be used to test certain drugs that depresses the fever. Okay, so if the drug is known to depress the fever response or pyrogenic response, then that drug you cannot test using sham test. Okay, because you will not detect any rise in temperature. So these are advantages and disadvantages. Then we are going to study about human cell based pyrogen test. Okay, so in this test we are going to exploit the reaction of monocyte against any pyrogen. Okay, so if a pyrogen is present in blood, the monocytes are known to release pro-inflammatory cytokines such as interleukins in response to the pyrogen. Okay, so we are going to determine the production or the or release of these interleukins. Okay, so IL-1 beta is the interleukin that is released by released by monocyte, and these interleukins can be then determined by ELISA after incubation. Okay, so this is a cell based pyrogen test. Then last we are going to study about depyrogenation, that is removal of pyrogen. So there are two methods: physical method and inactivation. Okay, so this is the removal. These are the methods that can remove the pyrogen from your glass vials or your solution. Okay, so you can dilute the solution so that it will not show any pyrogenic effect. Next is ultrafiltration, then reverse osmosis. So by these filtration and reverse osmosis method, you can remove your pyrogen. Then there is distillation, adsorption on charcoal, and column chromatography. Okay, so these are physical methods used for removal of pyrogen. Then next is inactivation. So dry heat sterilization. Regarding this, we had already seen that in our test procedure, in sample preparation, we had used our glass vials or diluents, which are heated at 250 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes and 200 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. So that is the example of dry heat sterilization. Moist heat sterilization example is autoclaving. Then another method for inactivation is oxidation, alkylation, and use of dilute acids and bases. You can use dilute acids and bases for washing your glass vials. So by this way, you can inactivate your pyrogen. Hope you like this video, and do mention in comments if you want videos regarding another topics. Thank you.